Okay guys, so in the last video we covered how to create a textual watermark, and in this one we're going to go over how to set up your graphical watermarks. So we're going to go back to the Edit menu, go to Edit Watermarks. This is going to bring up your watermark editor, and then we're going to choose the watermark style as being a graphic this time, not a text. Right away it's going to bring up the open dialog box, and if you look right here, I've selected a landscape image, so the aspect ratio is landscape versus portrait like this image. So I'm going to select the landscape stamp overlay. But you'll notice in this stamp what it is basically is it's an 850 pixel wide by 567 pixel tall image, and everything in the image is transparent except for this little bar that goes across the bottom. That's our stamp bar. And I have the stamp bar extending from edge to edge. So if I actually put this over a portrait image, it's going to cut off right here, so it's not really going to fade out. I'll kind of illustrate that, but I'm going to select this for right now. Hit choose, and you might not have seen anything happen because the settings are actually incorrect. The watermark actually did appear, it's just right here, tiny off to the left on the bottom left side of the screen, or the image. So we're going to go through our options now and kind of fix that. So right now we've already selected our image. We don't need our text options because we don't have, it's not a text watermark. So the watermark effect, we want it to be, most likely you want this to be 100% opaque, unless you want it. If you want some form of transparency, you can always reduce that, but I have the transparency already built into the image, so I want it to show up at 100% opaque. Next thing is the proportion. Now, like I said, if your stamp isn't necessarily sized to a certain image size, then you might want to use, actually you definitely want to use a proportional amount, but because this one is actually pre-sized to what I want, I can really do anything here. I can set this to 100%, and right away you'll see the linear that goes right across the bottom. I can set it to fit, or I can set it to fill. It's not going to matter because this image, this graphic was actually already pre-sized. Okay, so I'm going to go down here to my next options. The inset is actually the tabbing, basically. So the horizontal tabbing going across, as well as the tabbing from the vertical tabbing, which is the top and bottom tabbing. So this is just kind of like a margin, essentially, which it's going to be based on the anchor point that you have set here. And the anchor point is basically how it's positioning the image, or the stamp relative to the image. So right now it's set to bottom left. If I set this to center, then this is just going to act like a left-right margin, basically. Okay, and this is going to act like a top or bottom margin. You can see it pulling in and extending out. Okay, so I'm going to leave those at zero because, again, this is already pre-sized. And that's it. So I'm going to save this watermark. We're going to save it as a new preset. We'll call it the LJP horizontal stamp. Oh, that's already in use. We'll say number two, create. Okay. So now you might be asking, well, I don't really want to set up two stamps, one for like portrait orientation images and one for landscape orientation images. I want to just have one stamp that works the same way on all images. Okay, we can do that. Now, with this particular stamp, it might not work that well because this stamp was designed to fade off based on the width of a landscape image. So if I had it on a portrait image, it wouldn't fade off quite as quickly. So I can show you what that would look like, basically. I'm going to select this image now. I'm going to go back to Edit Watermark so we can kind of see the preview. I'm going to select the LJP Horizontal Stamp 2, and you can see a couple different things. Number one, the size is actually a little bit different because it stayed the same size on this. It doesn't fade off at the edges because it's designed to be much, much bigger. So basically, if you want to make a kind of like a one-size-fits-all stamp, it needs to be smaller, like small enough that it'll fit well both into landscape and portrait images. Okay, so I have a different graphic that I have set up, and I'm going to show you guys how to do that. And this, by the way, we could set it to, like if I just set it to, if I just set it to proportional, and then I move this to the bottom, so it anchors at the bottom. This is actually the same size, sorry. At proportional 100%, it will actually be the same size as the other one because it's sized to that. And it fades off okay, it's not a big deal. We'll actually save this, and we'll just update the current preset. Okay, so now if I export both of these images, I'll just export them to my desktop. And this is, by the way, how you actually apply the settings in export. So I'm going to set this to just a web sized on my desktop. And we'll go over this full kind of export process in a future chapter. Actually, I'm going to set it to desktop. There we go. And then I'm going to go down here and I'm going to set my watermark to horizontal stamp 2. I hit export. Okay, I'm going to go to my desktop. I have this folder where it all appeared. Okay, so there we have the first image, and here we have the second. And you'll notice that maybe we can open up both so we can preview side by side. Let's see, there's one and two. Okay, and you'll notice that in both of these, the stamp is the same size because we used proportional. We didn't have it fit. If it was fitting or if it was filling, then they're actually going to show up as different sizes in each image. But because we did the fill, or because we did proportional at 100%, it retains the same size as the stamp itself. So it's the same height and the same width, but on this one, you don't see it fade off to completely transparent, whereas in this one you do, because on the original file, it fades off at the edges. Okay, so that's not really a big deal. I don't really mind that on the blog if it's slightly different, you know, on a portrait versus a landscape image. But if you did mind that and you want to set it up so it looks exactly the same on each, you got to choose a stamp that's a little bit smaller. That's not the full width of like a landscape image. I'll show you what that would look like. So I'm going to go back to Edit Watermarks. I'm going to choose another image. And you can either hit Choose Image here. If you hit Choose here and you select one, it'll automatically switch this watermark style to graphic. So we'll just hit Choose, and I'm going to select just our logo. And this is already prepared on a transparent background. Okay, so there it pops in the logo at the bottom left, and it's kind of too small right now, so I want the proportion to be like maybe 25% of the original image, and it's important in this that you set a correct proportion, basically a constant proportion, if you want it to appear the same in every image, because otherwise with the fit or fill, it's going to basically fit, with fit, it's going to fit that image into, it's going to basically keep it the same size as the file. With fill, it's going to fill it to whatever size you're exporting. Okay, with proportional, it's going to keep it the same size in relation to its original size on every single file. Next, I'm going to go down, and here's my opacity. You guys can see the opacity. If I adjust it down, it becomes less opaque. If I take it back up, it becomes more opaque. So now with my inset, I actually want to use inset this time because I want it to appear tabbed in, because right now it's right on the edge. I want it to come in a little bit. And I also want to change my anchor point. Maybe I want it to be, I don't necessarily want it at the top of the image because that's kind of like right in your face, but maybe at the bottom of the image. And if I select the bottom center, then the horizontal inset will actually fade out because it really doesn't matter because it's centered at the bottom. But if I select left or right, then it will give me the option of having a horizontal inset. Okay, so I'm going to go to center, and then let's do a vertical inset so it's not like right at the very bottom of the image, and we'll set it to 4. And it looks a little bit big still. I'm going to set this to maybe 20. And maybe I'll adjust this to 3, just to, well, 2 is good, to bring it down a little bit. Now if I save this as a new preset, and we'll call this LJP, this is going to be one size fits all preset. I hit create, I hit done. Now here I'm just going to bring up my export dialog box. So I want the one size fits all preset. I'm going to hit export, and then let's go back here and let's check it out. Okay, so in both images, we have the exact same size stamp on both sides. It's placed in the same place. Obviously, this kind of dark image probably wouldn't work. This dark text wouldn't work over every image. You probably want something lighter, or maybe something that has like a little bit of kind of like white or black underneath it so that it kind of pops out over the image. But that's how you guys create a graphical watermark that will work on every single image, regardless of your export dimensions, regardless if it's a portrait or landscape image.